Hi Hat Productions. I'm Rebecca Whitmore. I'm the producer and co-editor of this project.
I'm Owen. I'm the co-producer.
And my name's Tom, and I'm the creative director and lead camera operator. So here we've got our concept, and first of all, the song we've chosen to do is the song called Make It by Avril Lavigne. It's a previously unreleased song, but we've learned about that, and we'll discuss it further in the next few slides. The song, its lyrics are about feeling comfortable in your own skin without having to wear makeup. Because in today's society, a lot of girls, and even now, a lot of guys feel like they have to wear makeup to feel accepted in society. And a lot of people are looked down upon for not wearing makeup or seen as less beautiful. So this song is about empowering people, especially women, to feel more confident without makeup. So for the concept for a song, we've envisioned having the lead actor in a house with a couple of her friends. She goes into a bathroom after picking up some bad memories about people bullying her for not wearing makeup and not looking like as a girl with makeup on. And then while in the bathroom, thinking about having these flashbacks to these bad thoughts, she notices an inspirational quote from her past, and this quote empowers her to take control and be a lot more confident in her own skin. So she removes her makeup off, and then throughout the remainder of the song, we see her going down different places like town centres, city streets, with no makeup on, feeling very confident. She will also be lip syncing with the song to get the message across through words as much as visualisations. And although for the rest of the song we're going to have her walking down different streets, it may seem a little bit boring, but through the use of camera angles and camera movements, we're going to be able to keep the audience captivated throughout. Now for our inspirations, when I was thinking of the concept for this, we got inspiration from a variety of different songs. A few of our top music video inspirations were mainly Avril Lavigne, as you can see, but also some of Paramore's most recent songs, such as the one in the middle here, where she's walking down loads of locations, but throughout the whole song, but it manages to get the audience captivated.
We did some research into statistics revolving around makeup and how people feel self-confident with this. We have learned that about 1 in 3 women won't leave the house without wearing foundation, and also only 15% of women are happy with their natural appearance and wouldn't change a bit.
So here we've got our storyboards. This is just for the short preview that we're going to be showing at the end for you guys. It shows you our lead actor. In the current bathroom, she sees the quote, and then she feels empowered, and she heads into the living room where her friends are to walk out. And this is the short list we had for each of our storyboards. They go into a lot more detail about each particular scene, what the actor and the camera operators need to do, what the light technicians need to make sure, and also what anyone else that's in the background needs to make sure they're not in shot. Or perhaps if we're even filming on the road, you know, we're going to assign separate lookouts to make sure we're all safe in there. And here is the equipment that we've decided to book out. We've got this standard Nikon DSLR, which is easily available to us. We've all had about 2 to 3 years' experience with it, so we're very handy with it, and we know our way about the camera. And we've enlisted the help of the stabilizer as well to help us with some of the more difficult tracking shots to keep it stable. And if that fails, we've also got, in the bottom right, we've got a video camera here, which produces really smooth tracking shots as well. We've also booked out a tripod just as a backup option in case some of our shots aren't steady. And then we've booked out a lighting reflector.
Initially, we were going to use some studio lighting that we were going to plug into the mains, but this proved to be sort of too bulky as well, too expensive for us to run out. So instead, we chose to use this over here in case we need any additional light, which just attaches onto the camera and runs up its battery.
We would need a crew of about 3 to 4 people to be able to man this and make sure everything is going as smoothly as possible. We'd also need about 4 to 5 cast members starring in the production, starring as the lead singer and her friends. We'd also Tom and Owen are being camera operators for this project, so they can keep an eye on what each shot's going to look like and where we need the cameras. I'm going to be starring within this production, but I will also be producing this so I can keep sure everything's on schedule.
The locations that we picked, we ended up with three locations, although initially we had eight. These locations are 140 Maker Road South in Loughborough, the Town Market in Loughborough, and 120 Thurkeston Road in Leicester. The accessibility was a key concern, so all of these locations are either on bus routes or train routes. We've requested permission for all of them, but we've not got anything official back yet, so that may all be subject to change, but at least Thurston Road and Midford South should be completely fine. It's just the Town Market that we've got some concerns about.
We have requested permission for all these locations, so we've spoken to the council and the homeowners about if we can use their locations and their homes. With the council, we may encounter some issues, such as if we have to record somewhere, we need to sort out the roads and kind of like block it up in case we don't want anyone to get hurt or anything. So that may become an issue. We've also requested permission from the artist and the record label to make sure that we've got correct use and we're going above copyright and making sure it's okay for us to use.
So, for health and safety, the two main concerns are electricity and cars. Some of our equipment requires, obviously, electricity, usually mains electricity, and we need to check every kind of plug socket with a qualified technician. That just makes sure that no one's going to get electrocuted by anything faulty. The other main concern is cars. We're filming quite close to some busy roads, and we don't want anyone to get hit by a car or anything. So we're going to see if we can get traffic diverted and roads shut down. If not, we'll have crew members behind our actors and behind some of our camera operators just to make sure no one backs into a road or does anything kind of dangerous.
If you turn to page 10 in your pitch pack, you'll see that there is a gantt chart in there. We've included some key dates for our production, such as the filming, so we've included the start and end date for filming, reshoot, editing, and we've also included a date for when we plan to export. We've included all our previous tasks, such as when we were individually working and coming together with what I didn't want to come forward with, as well as providing the pre-production documents and also practicing and rehearsing for this pitch. You'll also notice on there that some of the tasks overlap. This is intentionally done so we can film and then edit, so we can learn where we've gone, where we need to reach you and where that footage fits within our edit plan.
Is our test footage.
Next slide.
Yep.
Any questions? Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
The research that you had, was that primary research that you did yourself, or was that from a secondary source?
That was from a secondary source.
Right, from the internet? I couldn't even know
from
that.
From the internet, yeah.
I was going to ask, kind of, Tom, it was a section you were talking about, but anyone feel free to answer. You talked about flashbacks. Were you going to have a way of differentiating the flashbacks from the kind of the normal time period?
The flashbacks are going to be produced with a kind of a sepia cover over it, so we can tell that it's not from the same time period.
Okay, cool. One big question I've got, and I'm really happy you're attempting it, but it's not the easiest to do, is the lip sync. Have you had a think about how that works and the logistics of...
Actually, I've been watching a lot of music videos being produced on YouTube, such as previous Avril Lavigne videos from Her Let Go Era.
Yeah.
And I can see some of the difficulties in doing that.
Yeah.
But one thing that we can make that easier is by playing music in the background while we're filming each shot loud enough. And if that doesn't work, we can also try and get earphones in the person's ear or have someone with a piece of paper in front of them so they can read out the words on screen to the music player.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we've definitely considered that and tackled it as a
feature. That's the new Beck being the lip syncer.
We've storyboarded the whole thing out, so it should be all right to kind of, you know, the edits weren't too jarring and stuff.
Yeah.
So for locations, you said about, or kind of the general kind of feeling of walking through the streets when just feeling empowered without the makeup on. So where will that be, sorry? Just Loughborough Town Centre?
So we've chosen Loughborough Town Centre because it's a hotspot for kind of crowds and different people. We've also chosen a few different main roads just because we kind of want busy to kind of really busy locations, so there's a lot of people. But we've also chosen one or two quiet locations.
Okay.
And the reason we want the actor walking down the streets is to get reactions from the public. But we've specifically got cast members. We've selected people to star them to act as the trainers.
Right, that's why I was just wondering whether the public are just.
And even though we're filming
the
public,
whether it's kind of staged.
We won't be directly filming the public, we'll be directly filming the actor, so the focus won't be on the public.
Right, okay. I was just thinking whether it would get a little bit kind of tedious if the majority of the video is just kind of walking down different streets.
But we feel like the camera angles and camera movements used throughout help keep the audience captivated, you know.
Okay. It's not that long of a song, so it shouldn't be, even if it should be too tedious, whatever.
Have you got an idea of who the additional people are? Because you said you need three or four or five.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not sure if you've got
pretty much 90% of people are my friends. They were happy to do it, and they were really easily available.
Very good.
Okay. And contingency plan for locations, so do you always send back the permissions?
Yeah.
For the houses, is that kind of your own houses?
These are our houses, yeah.
So that should be fine. Right. I was just wondering whether you had kind of a contingency plan.
We've sent some stuff off the local council to see if we can film in the marketplace.
Yeah.
There might be certain restrictions on the days we can film. If we're bringing lots of equipment and stuff. Of course, they've got the all the markets on and stuff on Friday and outside of it and stuff.
Yeah.
But if we film, say, on a Monday or a Tuesday when nothing's really on, it should be totally fine. So we have applied for permission just in case.
Okay.
All
right. Yeah, that's everything. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.